another episode of Digital Electronics by Practical Ninjas. The previous video covers De Morgan's theorem. In this video, we will see the remaining laws of Boolean algebra. Understanding these laws will help you remember them forever. Let's draw the AND gate. The inputs of AND gate can be represented by switches in series. You can refer to our previous videos on this. Let one input be variable A and the other input be A's complement, that is A bar. Suppose A is 1 or a closed switch, its complement A bar will be 0 or an open switch. Let's take another scenario where A is 0, then A bar will be 1. In such cases, AND gate gives a 0 output. If a variable is ANDed with its complement, the circuit will always be open. Therefore, A and A bar is 0. The next scenario is that the first input of AND gate is 1, so one switch will be on. Let the other input be variable A. Now A can be 0 or 1. If A is 0, AND operation produces 0 output. If A is 1, then the output is 1. That is, the output is dependent on this variable A. A and 1 gives A. However, if the first input is 0, then let the value of A be 0 or 1. The output will always be 0. The circuit will always be open. A and 0 gives 0. Let us draw the OR gate. The two inputs are shown by switches connected parallelly. Now one input is 0, thus this path is open. The other is variable X. The value of X determines the output. If X is 0, output is 0. That is, the path is not connected. If X is 1, the output is high as the path is closed. Thus, X or 0 is X. Let the first input be 1. Here the path is always connected, which makes the output high. In OR gate, as long as one input is at logic 1, the output is high. X or 1 is 1. Consider a multiple input OR gate. Let all the inputs be at the same logic level. Let us call them X. If all the inputs are at logic 1, output is high. And if all the inputs are low, the output is low. The logic level present at the input is given at the output. Thus, X or X or X and so forth is X. The same logic applies for an AND gate. X and X and X and so forth gives X. Consider X and Y as two inputs for AND gate. The output can be written as X and Y, or we can say Y and X. Both are equivalent. The same is true for an OR operation. The output is X or Y or X. This is called commutative law. Consider this logical expression. The order in which you solve the logical expression has no significance. All three terms are equal. This is called associative law. This law is also applicable for AND gate. So, X and Y and Z is same as Y and Z and X, which equals Z and X and Y. Consider the term X and Y. Another expression is X and Z. Let's solve both of them. Now we see that X is distributed to both the expressions. We take X outside the parenthesis. Thus, Boolean algebra follows distributive law. Consider another example. We can distribute X over the parenthesis and later Y over the parenthesis. Remember to keep the Boolean operation same. Let's expand the terms. X and X or X and Z. This is an OR operation. Y and X or Y and Z. X and X is X itself. From these two terms, let's take X outside the parenthesis. You all know that 1 or Z is 1. We are left with only X. let's solve the next term. We will again take x outside the parenthesis. Finally, we have x and the last term. We will represent the expression using logic gate to see the difference between the two. There are three inputs, x, y and z. We take two OR gates. The outputs of these two go as inputs to the AND gate. For the simplified expression, there is one AND gate followed by an OR gate. As we can see, the number of gates is reduced. Thus, the time taken to reach the output has also reduced. Let us solve some logical expressions to understand better. Let's see an interesting logical expression. When I'm trying to solve this function, I can't find a way to simplify it. This term contains a literal x and the next term contains a literal x bar, that is its complement. The last term is a combination of the other two literals, y and z. There is a trick to solve such expressions. Eliminate the last term from the given expression. Let's prove this. Here the last term is y and z. We can also say it's y and z and 1 as it would mean the same. This 1 can be replaced with x or x bar since this term equals to 1. So it won't change the output. We will expand the last term. We find that some of the literals are common in certain terms. Let's rearrange the terms. This is the final expression. It is called the consensus law. That's all for today, folks. The next video will be on universal gates. Subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to get notified. Stay calm and keep learning. Peace out.